Praise the Lord. It is a joyful time that I could come over here and stand here with the Word of God. And so wonderful, even though we are not big crowd, that from the very beginning it was so live, and we are praising God and thanking God for everything. I thank Pastor Johnson and all those who are others here for giving me this opportunity. My name is Varughis, and I pastor the church in Toronto in Canada right now. And for the last many years, it was my joy to serve the Lord across the nations and around the world. And it is also a joyful thing that I could come here and to be with you. And first of all, I simply wanted to thank my Lord, and I thank all those who are here, the elders and the pastor who are here. And I just want to spend the rest of the time bringing out the joyful thing in the presence of God that has been given to us from God's word. To, you know, it was so interesting to have, you know, the brothers, those who are here, participating in every kind of items, whether it is song or Bible quiz or whatsoever. It was so wonderful thing, and leading and guiding. You know, this service, and the Bible says that where two or three are gathered in His name, He is there in the midst of them. So He is the one who is to be honored, to be lifted up in our life. I thought I should ask one question also before I enter into the Word of God. That question is quite a simple question. Maybe, you know, give chance to somebody who will be responding to that question. My question is this: there is a book in the New Testament that is written to a lady. Which is that book? In the New Testament, a book that is written to a lady. You are right, Second John. Okay, so there are many questions that I could ask, but simply to just get the attention, I asked for that question. It was my joy to have the fellowship yesterday in the place called Manchester, and there is the place that I met Pastor Johnson, Dev Raj, and also the family, and all others from different places. God is so great and God is so wonderful. And I always am thankful to the Lord for the way that God has called me for the ministry. And every time when I remember how God has been so much loving towards me, and I just give myself at His feet. The Lord called me in the year 1964, and that wonderful day I will never forget. And God, when He called me, He gave me His assurances from God's word, and that's the reason why for the last 52 years I could serve the Lord, and 48 years preaching the gospel. And it is so wonderful, and I do not know how to thank my God. The love that God has given, you know, towards me as a very young boy. I was born in 1952, and you can just imagine, I was only 11 and a half years old. God called me for His ministry, and the words that He gave me at that time was being found in the book of Jeremiah. I'm not going to preach from there, but I just wanted to giving you a little testimony of my life. And it was from book of Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 4 onwards. The word of the Lord came to me saying, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations. Alas, sovereign Lord, I said, I do not know how to speak. I am too young. But the Lord said to me, do not say I am too young. You must go to everyone I sent you to and say, whatever I commanded you, do not be afraid of them, for I am with you and will rescue you, declares the Lord. Then the Lord reached out his hand and touched my mouth and said to me, I have put my words in your mouth. See, today I appoint over nations and kingdoms to uproot and tear down, to destroy and overthrow, to build and plant. The word of the Lord came to me. What do you see, Jeremiah? And there onwards, you know, you can read later. This is the word that came to me. I went to a place that was not known to me at all. God's Spirit led me to that particular congregation. And I was coming from a very orthodox tradition. But first time I went to a place where the people of God really coming and worshiping the Lord. And that is a place when I went over there, I didn't know many of the things what they are doing, and like us today, morning singing and praising God and worshiping the Lord and so on. So it is that place when I went and sat over there, a Lord's servant came and touched me and gave me the words in my heart, and also through this book of Jeremiah. And I remember that day. Until that day, I was a very sick person. Very sick means severely sick. All my hair were brown in color because of the sickness. And I have been taken all the doctors in my town. My town is not a bad town. It's a good town with so many hospitals. It's one of the good area that we had in Kerala in India. So that town was very famous for many of the hospitals. Even today, there are two medical colleges there and all the other hospitals. But every hospital said, you know, it is not possible that he will not be healed. He will die very soon. And one final place my mother has taken me to test and also to see the doctor. And I was holding, you know, her hand, and she was holding me close to her while the doctor came and talking to her. And I saw that my mother is crying, and she knew that I'm going to die very soon. And the sicknesses, they were not able to find out exactly what it is. The things have been happening in the liver, and as a result, it has been, you know, my hairs were all brown in color. We, you know, as young people, we always have the black hairs, but it's all brown in color. And finally, when the doctor said that, whatever he needs, you give him. Let him eat. He's going to die very soon. And my mother was crying, and the tears were coming even to my own body because I was leaning on her. And that particular day, 1964, March 14th, Wednesday, I went to that church first time, to a church that is charismatic, a church that is Pentecostal. So I went over there, sat there, and the servant of the Lord who came to minister never knew me, because he came from a far place to that church, and that church doesn't belong to us. It's a strange church. First time we went to that kind of a church. And all of a sudden, he came and touched me and said these words. And also, he asked me to pray. And I was sitting there crying, literally crying, because I knew that I'm going to die, you know, very soon. And I prayed to God, Lord, have mercy upon me. And I accepted Jesus Christ first time in that church. And I gave my heart to the Lord. And Jesus Christ came into my heart. Within maybe 10 to 15 minutes, I have been filled with the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
I started speaking in tongues. And I never stopped, even until today I can continue.
Amen.
And the way that God began to touch me was the transformation not only of my inner man, but the transformation of my outer man.
Hallelujah.
And I have been filled with the Holy Spirit. And I was worshiping the Lord. The meeting started at 7:30 p.m. and it ended at 10:30, and I knew that I was rolling down, sweeping with the power of God, and the skin of my knees have been going, and I know that the power has been in such a way that it has been coming and touching me. And once I got up as a wonder to my mother and to all the people, all my hair became black.
Hallelujah.
That is the day the healing started in my life. Hallelujah. And I know that there is a God who can do great and wonderful things in our life. And this morning I just wanted to assure you that if you are here with any kinds of difficulties and problems, there is a God who can touch you, God who can heal you. Instead of trusting anybody else, trust in the Lord. And He is going to do it. Young boy started. After 48 years of ministry, still I'm looking for places where I have not gone. I have traveled 22 countries in the world, and the next invitation is waiting for me to go to Australia and New Zealand. And I know that God can do wonderful things.
Amen.
We submit ourselves
Amen.
In the hands of the Lord.
Amen.
If we are going to give ourselves in the hands of the Lord,
Amen.
The thing that God is going to do for you and me, we have never seen it, but He knows it.
Yes.
And we know that God can do the great and mighty things in our lives. And God can really do the things that He can transform us in a greater way. No matter where you have come, there will be differences in your life. There will be differences in your life. There will be differences in your life. And if you submit yourself completely to God, He can do it.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. And that is what God wants us to do.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank God, I, my wife and three children. And we were living in the United States a couple of years before. God told one day, just pack up everything, go back to India. And I just asked my wife, be ready, we will be going. And she asked me one question, how can we all five go immediately and buy five tickets? And it was something that has been a problem, because I was doing my PhD in the Westminster seminary, and I was finishing almost, but God told us to go back to India. And I told my wife, be ready, pack it, and God is going to do a great thing.
Amen.
Children, all those who were growing in the US, you know, naturally the way is that they all wanted to stay there. But I told my wife and children, let's pack everything and go to India. God wants us to start a wonderful thing in our life. And I simply wanted to let you know that how God is providing the things. And I want each one of you to trust the Lord and see that how God can provide the things. We were ready, and I called one of my friends and said that we are going back to India. He asked, what is this you are talking about? People are always trying their level best to come to America, and you are saying that you want to go back to India. I said, yes, God told. So we prepared ourselves to go within 14 days to India, and in the mail, we got all the air tickets.
Wow, praise God.
I didn't even spend $1. But God has been so wonderful.
Praise God.
I trusted the Lord, and I tell you that not even one person, from the day I accepted Jesus as my Savior, I never let any of my needs to be known to any man. God is a provider.
Amen.
And believe that, and He can do all things. Praise the Lord. Yesterday while I was speaking in Manchester, I told them how God provided the visa for coming to this place yesterday to speak. Just for that, God has done miracles.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Simply because I asked the visa department to give back my passports, because in my church in Toronto, you know, we had an engagement that is to be done for one family's daughter. And for that to go to US from Canada, I needed my passport. And I requested, but the passport was in the UK visa office. So they gave me an answer that we need 3 weeks to, you know, give you back your passport. But what happened is that I requested, please don't put the visas, don't send it, wherever it is, to get it back. And they told, 72 hours we will take and we will just bring you a passport to Toronto. And within that, the next, 24 hours, you will get your passport. And I was waiting, and what happened, I just wanted to let you know what happened, only last week thing. And they told that your passport will be ready. Within 4 days, it will be in your hand, but we will not be getting time to print the visa for the UK. And here the people were praying for me to come to, you know, UK to preach in that graduation service. I did not know how these two things will take together. So the UK visa department has informed that you will get back to your passport, but we are not sure whether you will get a visa for the UK. So I was waiting, and I got the reply in that way that evening at 3:30, instead of taking 4 days, I got the information from the UK visa office, come and collect your passport. I thought I can collect my passport, but there will be no visa for UK, simply because I didn't give them time. And when I went over there, I got my passport. Immediately I looked through, there was already UK visa. And that's the reason why I could come yesterday to the place where we had our graduation service.
Amen.
I just wanted to affirm you, the Church of Jesus Christ, I will, from my own life, I can give you hundreds of examples. Yesterday I gave one example how I went to West Indies without a visa, and God let me in. God can do great and mighty things, and we need to experience the power of God. And I will cut short my testimony simply because I need to come to the Word of God. But I want you to know that experience the great power of God.
Amen.
Experience the great power of God and see the miracles from God. You know, so God called me, and He just sent me back to India. And I went over there, and we went to the place in Bangalore. You might have heard that place. We went to Bangalore, and we started working over there. There were only one person who has been filled with the Holy Spirit in that place. We gathered together. At the most, 7 or 8 people we got gathered. And God began work. And I wanted to encourage you, church, say this. And we have been praying. And I asked the Lord, Lord, show us your guidance in this place for 1 year and give us the directions. And we began to pray. And when my wife sleeps in the bedroom, I will just get up, go to the church, open the door, and I will walk up and down, cry in the presence of God, and ask God to do the great and mighty things in that place. God began to bring the people. And I took 4 years in that place, and the church hall was packed. And people began to sit outside. And it was time for me to come and take charge as the registrar of the Assemblies of God College in Punalur. So I said goodbye to that church, handed over to my assistant pastor. And God began to continue doing the work. Today, I simply wanted to say that there are more than 7,000 people in that church in Bangalore. That is the way that God began to do the thing. And my assistant pastor is more powerful than me, I tell you. And he began to do a great work. Today, wonderful works are going on in Bangalore. You might have heard, you know, about that church, Bethel Assembly of God Church. And the pastor, M.A. Varughis, he is the one who is now ministering over there. God is a great God. Believe, when I just first, you know, you are only 8 people here, and I thought that, yes, God, This is another experience that I could see that in the literally you two families came over, and I counted 8 people. Oh, it is just Noah's Ark that we are going to have this morning, Lord, and have the kind of worship. But God is a great God. If you believe in, you know, and trust in the Lord, God can give people into our churches. It's not we working, but it is He who is at work. And let us continue to give the praises and glory to Him. And this morning, I wanted to turn my attention to the Gospel according to St. Luke. Gospel according to St. Luke. And chapter 10. Luke chapter 10. We will be taking few verses which are very familiar. Luke 10 verses 38 through 42. A passage which is known to everyone. As Jesus and his disciples were on their way, he came to a village where a woman named Martha opened her home to him. She had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. She came to him and asked, "Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me." "Martha, Martha," Lord answered, "you are worried and upset about many things, but few things are needed, or indeed only one. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from her." I know that you all are well versed with this passage, and I'm going to give you a very simple thing that is going to really talk to us and will be giving us challenge in our life, how to be with the Lord Jesus Christ and follow the things that are children of God. This is a journey that Jesus is doing actually to Jerusalem, and that is the context in which that it is. And while Jesus was going on Jerusalem during the occasion of the Feast of the Booths, and this is the in time that while he was taking his disciples along with him and going into these places, and we see that as Jesus and his disciples were on their way, he came to a village where a woman named Martha opened her home to him. And we know the backgrounds, and I'm not going to explain that much. And it says that while they were going, a woman coming to the road, coming to the wayside, maybe, you know, Lazarus' house might have been on the wayside. And that's the reason why she could come, while Jesus and disciples were going through the road, she could come and invite them to come to the home. And this Martha has, you know, invited Jesus Christ, and he got inside the house. And you just see that she's the one inviting Jesus. She is the one giving an invitation to this house. But after inviting Jesus Christ, what did she do? After inviting Jesus Christ, where is Martha? After inviting Jesus, what time did she spend with Jesus Christ? Did she take a time with the Lord? Maybe this is an experience that we all are having, you know, in our life. There are dangers sometimes in spiritual life that we invite Jesus Christ and leave him alone, and we take our own ways. And we take our own, you know, matters so serious, and we leave even though we invited him sometimes in our life. Sometimes we have invited him as the Lord and Master, and we can leave him, and we are so much interested in the matters that we give importance. This is exactly what has happened in the life of Martha. She invited him, but where are you, Martha, now? Are you with Jesus Christ? What are you doing? What is your interest in? Is that you are only having the interest of inviting him in the life and not to have the life along with spending so that you will be growing in the grace of the Lord. God is expecting us not only that we are inviters of Jesus Christ, but we should be spending our time day by day with Him so that we can grow in God's grace and in God's power. It is not simply that once we have accepted Jesus Christ, it's not simply once we said that we become a Christian. By that we are only starting, you know, our Christian life. But the time that God is giving us is to spend the time with Him.
Amen.
Spend the time really so that we will be growing and edified day by day in the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
It is easy for us to invite Him and go away from Him. But God wants us to understand that if you are a child of God, there should be a growth that is very substantial. A growth that will produce fruit in our life. And take 24 hours of a day. And how much we spend our time with the Lord Jesus Christ. Many people are so much saying about Jesus Christ, we are Christians, but sometimes our relationship with Jesus Christ is not so fruitful, and we are not taking enough time in our life with the Lord Jesus Christ. Understand that the trouble that Martha had also can happen to us. Maybe I'm a preacher, maybe you are an elder, maybe you are somebody who is doing a ministry, but remember one thing, you should have quality time to be spending with the Lord Jesus Christ. Monday
we
have 24 hours, and if you believe in tithing, how much time you should give to God daily?
2.4 hours,
you are very smart. Can you say how many hours and minutes?
2 hours 40 minutes.
2 hours 40 minutes? No? Oh, it's only, you know, to take the 1/10 of, you know, 24 hours, surely. As naturally you think that it is 2 hours 40 minutes, but it is 2 hours 24 minutes. So, okay, so understand that we need to spend at least 2 hours 24 minutes if we would have been believing in tithing with the Lord Jesus Christ. But think about how much time we really take in the presence of God daily. The only one day we tithe is only Sunday. How much time we, you know, really spend in the presence of God? Martha so much happily went outside, invited Jesus from the road, asked Him to come inside my home, and be seated. Martha, where are you? She's not with Jesus. She's not spending any minutes with Jesus. And she is somewhere there where she's interested cooking something. And you will naturally say that it is to feed Jesus. But Jesus said, I am inside not to have your feast. I am inside to spend the time with you. But you are not there with me. You invited me, true, maybe, you know, 48 years before or 52 years before, I invite Jesus in my heart. But are you with Jesus Christ? How many years before you came to the Lord, I do not know. But are you really with Jesus? During those days, you know how to pray. During those days, you know how to spend the time, you know, with the Word of God. But today, are you with the Lord Jesus Christ, spending your quality time so that you can have a real communion with Him, so that He can talk to you, so that He can commune with you? Is it only when you are coming inside the church that we are with the Lord? Are we with our Lord Jesus Christ? It is nice to be intimate with Jesus. Intimacy should be showing through the fellowship. Praise the Lord. And the Bible says that in next verse you can see that she had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet listening to what He said. We don't see that Mary is going outside and inviting, but when He came inside, she decided one day, as He has come, the rest of all my time I spent at His feet.
it is my elder sister who has invited Jesus. But I want to spend my time with Jesus.
And the moment you can just watch that, it says, she had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet listening to what he said. She wanted to hear, not only accepting him, but she went and sat at his feet. She gave herself as a student of his speeches, student of his word, and to be with the Lord, so that she wanted to enjoy the fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ. For a child of God, we need to understand this matter very much, that if he is my teacher, if he is my Lord, my place is at his feet. Amen. I wanted to be with him, and not simply sitting with him, but rather to be with his feet, so that I can learn every minute from him. Every word he speaks to me, I wanted that to be in my life.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. What a joy it is to spend our time with the Lord Jesus Christ and his words. And if we are not going to do that, I know my timing, so let me go, you know, fast. If we are not understanding this, children of God, I simply as a servant of God, and maybe someone who has simply to say that a servant that I wanted to serve my God, wanted to tell you one secret of Christian life. Christian life is not simply coming to the church once in a week and spend the rest of the days for the world, but every day we are to have our time with the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Then only we can be transformed. Here this is an example. It's sure she invited, you know, Martha invited Jesus, but she was not available. It is a great thing to be as a child of God one particular day, but God wants us to continuously grow in the grace of the Lord, along with Jesus Christ. And if we are not having that, there is a danger that you can look at and you can see verse 40. Somebody wants to read that verse 40 so that you can just have a look at what it has been written. Verse 40.
But Martha was distracted with much serving.
Yes.
And she reproached him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve the Lord? Therefore tell her to help me.
You can see Martha invited, but verse 40 says that Martha was distracted. Did you ever think seriously about that? Martha has done the invitation, but just after one more verse it says that she was distracted. Invitation is good. Accepting Christ is good. Until unless you are with Jesus, every chance of distraction is there in our life. We are living in a very crooked world. We are living in a world with all of its enticements that is coming upon us, children of God. But remember, if we are not with Jesus, there is the danger of getting us distracted from the Lord Jesus Christ. Many times this is a temptation that the world of Christianity is facing. That is, we have enthusiasm to go and accept Jesus Christ, but many of the people are backslidden simply because they are not spending their time with God and his word and with prayer. And as a result, every kind of temptation can take us away from Christ, and there is the danger of distracting ourselves from God. Martha was distracted by all preparation. What are you doing, Martha? She will say, I'm preparing. For whom? For Jesus. But why you are distracted? You are not with Jesus. And she thought that she wanted to have a lot of delicious food so that she can just give that to Jesus Christ. Finally, you come at the end of that. Jesus directly said to her, Martha, I don't need all these things, I need only one. You are spending a lot of things for unnecessary time, unnecessary things, and you are not concentrating upon. I am not here in this house for to have a great dinner, but I am here only to have the fellowship with you. You are the one invited inside. When I came to see you, you are not there. I simply wanted to tell you, you are making yourself distracted from me by your own ways of preparation. What I desire from you is that you should have a close intimacy with me.
Amen. Amen.
And that is what verse is. Martha was distracted. And the one who received can also be in the danger of distraction. Once we have accepted Christ, if we are not sincere and if we are not honest, we can be distracted. Every day, you know, let us surrender ourselves to God's hand, that we will be living as real disciples of Jesus Christ. You know, Jesus did not come into this world to make people Christians. Nowhere it is written. If somebody thinks that Jesus came to make Christians, it's a wrong teaching. He did not come to make Christians. He came only to make disciples. Hallelujah. Disciple means just like the teacher. Just like the way that the teacher goes. And that is what is expected of us. And this is why he is desiring that when he is coming to have the greater fellowship. I hope that you are understanding that, you know, what I am coming into. As the children of God, as believers, you know, as we are having the experience with God's word, God wants us to grow just exactly like, you know, our Master and our Lord, the Savior. And he wants us to grow. And here, the distraction has so much that her life began to go away from all kinds of devotion that she had. She had a great devotion when she went to the road to invite him. But where is the devotion now? You look at verse 40, it says that Martha was distracted by all the preparation and had to be made. She came to him and asked, Lord, don't you care? Suppose you went and asked somebody, don't you care for me? What kind of a language that will be? She is the one who went and, you know, invited, you know, the Jesus inside. Now, instead of having that fellowship, he came and asked Jesus, accusing Jesus Christ and accusing Jesus for doing something wrong to her. She is, you know, accusing him with the words that you can see that, don't you care that my sister has left me to the work of myself, leaving me alone? And you can see that Martha has become a different person simply because she did all the preparation, but she has been distracted away from the Lord. We can do great things, so many things in our life, but if we are not concentrating on Christ, all what we do will not be bringing forth glory unto the name of the Lord. God wants us to have Jesus. The most likely thing that he wants us to have is our devotion to him, our relationship to him. We should be really a disciple of Jesus Christ, like him, that we should be growing in the grace of the Lord. And you can understand that it says her devotion has been affected. She was such a devoted lady, going even to the road and inviting him to the house. Such a great person was she. But the moment she came inside her home and she has been separated from Jesus, she was interested in preparing a lot of things but not cared about the Lord Jesus Christ. If this danger can happen to our life also. And if we are not being careful, you know, I can be a pastor, very busy pastor, traveling all the places, but God is demanding us that our relationship and intimacy with the Lord is the first to be taken care of than having any other things, having all the other matters. Give ourselves completely in the hands of the Lord so that I can have that intimate relationship continually in my life and in your life. This is very important that we need to, you know, understand. And it says that in this, you know, place, why she was distracted? Simply because her interest was not Jesus inside, but
her interest was something to cook inside. It's okay, somebody when comes home, you need to take care of them, but not at the expense of doing something which is not necessarily, you know, appreciated by the Lord Jesus Christ. And it says, you know, in the next verse you can see, Bharata was distracted by all the preparation that had to be made. She came to him and asked, Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me. She is the elder sister. She could come and talk to her younger sister and invite her. Please come and help me. Instead, now she's asking, Jesus, you tell, because she is sitting at your feet. I know that she is really taking advantage of me. And so you tell her to come, to, you know, get away from your feet. Once our devotion is lost, our interest is to even disturb somebody else. You know, always it is that you have to see that once our devotion is lost from the Lord Jesus Christ, we will be also interested to bring people, those who are at the feet of Jesus, to take them away so that they will also be like you. This is something which Jesus doesn't want to do that. And you can see that from this passage very clearly. Martha and Mary, they were very good friends, good sisters, very close relationship. Simply because she was sitting at the feet of Jesus, now she is angry. Martha, why are you so angry because your sister is sitting at the feet of Jesus Christ? Why do you want her to get up from that place? Why you don't want her to come and sit here, but someone who is sitting at the feet of Jesus, you don't want them to sit also? Go close to Jesus. Spend time with the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus is so happy that Mary is sitting at his feet and listening to the word. It is our responsibility as the children of God, growing in God's grace. Sometimes we think that we know everything. Sometimes we know that we are deep Christians. But to have that fellowship, be with the Lord Jesus Christ. Martha was coming and dictating and demanding Jesus what Jesus should do to Mary. In other words, she wanted to play a role of a dictatorship to Jesus Christ. Even though she, you know, demanded or at least requested Jesus to come inside. No, she is now dictating Jesus. You do like this. Let us be more in close connection with the Lord and have more things to be received from the Lord Jesus Christ. Actually, what Mary was doing, she was sitting at the Lord's feet. Nothing happened to Martha. She was not doing any damage to Martha. She could have told, even before she goes and sits at the feet of Jesus, Martha could have said that you come and help me also after half an hour or after 2 hours, but she didn't say anything. Now when she is sitting at the feet of Jesus in real intimacy with the Lord, she wants her to get up. Remember one thing, why she is so much having jealousy towards her? Always, not that she wanted to do something inside the kitchen, but she wanted to show that I am not getting that privilege, so you also should not get it. I am not getting the time with Jesus, so you also should not sit there. That attitude should not be there in our life every time that we are getting to spend our time with the Lord Jesus Christ. And it says that, Martha, Martha, the Lord answered. God is going to do the evaluation and then I will stop at this time. You know, God is going to do, Jesus is going to do the evaluation. Verse 41, Martha, Martha, the Lord answered, you are worried and upset about many things. Martha, spending all your time, what did you get? Bible says very clearly, Martha inherited a lot of worries and upsets. That is what she got. But Jesus evaluated Mary and said that, Martha, there are only few things needed. And And he qualified it and saying that only one thing that is needed. Mary had chosen the better, and it will not be taken away from her. Even if you take her away from my feet, what I have given inside her cannot be taken away.
Praise the Lord.
Even if you are jealous upon her, but what I have given to her cannot be taken away. And I wanted to tell you, what all the preparations you have done in the kitchen is not worth what I have given to her. That would have been enough for you to understand. You should have also come and sat at my feet, and you would have been blessed by the things. And Jesus evaluated her and said, Mary has chosen the better. Why it is so better? Why it is so better? What are the things that Martha, you have made in the kitchen? It can be taken away. But what I have given her, it will not be taken away from her by anyone.
Amen.
Quality. Life and intimacy with the Lord. It's not that I accepted Jesus years before. Is that is qualifying us? What did you receive from him today? That should be the better, not the worries and upsets. Christian world is many times upset with this worldly things, but Jesus said, do not worry about those things, but worry about what you can build up with. If you have all those things what Jesus has promised for you, no one can take away with you. What I have given, no one can spoil it. And don't worry about the money, the wealth, or the things of this world. All those things shall follow you. But you have the worth thing in your life, and that only will bring you to the eternity. May the dear Lord bless us to have that insight, so that we will be able to remain faithful ones even after number of years. One fine day we will hear the voice, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful in little. I will give you everything that is necessary in the things that being held in the kingdom that I have established for you. May the dear Lord bless us as we have listened God's word and continue to help you. Thank you for this opportunity that the Lord has given. God bless you.